The Sandbox is not a usual game. It is not even a usual blockchain game. It is an entire metaverse. The beauty of it is that it is an opportunity to build your own anything from scratch. What is more, your neighbor may be Snoop Dogg himself. Are you interested to hear more? Where Minecraft meets Second Life. You probably do not remember Second Life, or you have never heard of it. Do not worry, I am going to tell you everything you have to know about this game. It was created by Linden Lab in 2003. That is quite a long time ago. There was the time, about 2006, when the game was quite popular. At that time, Alan Grieve earned over $1 million by selling stuff in the game, which was quite an achievement in those days. Over time, it receives less attention. The purpose of Second Life was to create your own avatar and give it life. You could buy clothes, furniture, and even real estate. Honestly, I have never been a fan of that concept. That's all for now about this game. Minecraft was always a weird game for me. I never understood why people like it. The game is more or less about playing with bricks. It is even more ridiculous because our civilization has created the superior bricks, Lego. Okay, jokes aside, Minecraft is a very successful product. In 2014, Microsoft bought this game for $2.5 billion. Now, close your eyes and mix those games together. The result of it is The Sandbox. Or maybe it will be because the game is not done yet. But even though, it already has big investors like Snoop Dogg, The Walking Dead, Atari, The Smurfs, and so on. What can you do in the Sandbox metaverse? There are a couple of opportunities. Let us start with being a landlord. How to become one? You have to own a piece of the metaverse virtual land. Right now, it is not possible to buy any directly from the Sandbox developers, but you can get it secondhand on OpenSea. Right now, you have to be prepared to pay thousands of dollars for the cheapest one, but you can easily find that pieces of land cost over $1 million. When you become a proud owner, you will be able to design your place as you want. Besides that, the developers give you a special application called Game Maker. As you can easily guess, the app lets you create your own little game. Of course, you can do it only if you are a landlord. The creator. This is how I would call the person who makes all items for the game. It may be a car, gun, wall, table, monster, or whatever else you can think of. The creator will be able to sell own products to the players in the near future. The player, the most common profession in the Sandbox metaverse. The players will be able to enjoy the world created by others and play games made by them. At this very moment, we do not know how exactly it is going to work. We are still in very early stages when it comes to the development process. Let us talk about Sand Token. To begin, you should know how to use Sand Token and why it exists. Basically, it is the Sandbox metaverse currency. You could buy the land using it. Right now, you can pay for the game items in sand currency. Moreover, the token is really pricey these days. It had surged about 400% during the last months as of this recording. You may ask, is it too expensive now? It depends. If the sandbox will be developed without any problems, the price should go up and up with small corrections from time to time. This view is just my opinion and is not financial advice. Is the Sandbox a good project? It is really hard to answer at this present time. I feel that the Sandbox has the potential to become a very valuable venture. But, as I said before, we are still in the early stages in regards to the development process of the game and many things may happen along the way. This is why it is still a risky project. On the other hand, the project has the support of many big players like Snoop Dogg, Atari, Hell's Kitchen, The Smurfs, and more. Keep it in mind, And be smart about your investments and do your due diligence when it comes to research.